Our first video of the trip. This is the glamorous part of traveling. Just here at the airport. See, Mr. Marquez, how you doing, sir? There's the boys. Katie, hello, Katie. Good morning. Y'all tired?
Yes.
Ani Ma daily sugar intake.
This is the non-glamorous part as well of traveling. The boys over there waiting for their luggage. Harvey family over here. Some more waiting for their luggage.
And I will also take you up to New York City on Saturday, okay? And I'll be giving you a few facts about some of the places that you'll be visiting while you're in the DC area, right? We're gonna use this bus all 3 days, okay? On the outside, it says Haymarket, the bus to the Congress House, the U.S. Capitol.
First stop in D.C. is the Jefferson Memorial. See our peeps over here. Look at some just on that. Now we're at the Franklin Delano Roosevelt Memorial. Monument. There is him sitting down in a chair with the boys getting a picture. This monument goes through his four terms as president. Great Depression was included with that, along with World War II. He implemented during the Great Depression the Public Works Act, I think, to get people back working. We're at the Martin Luther King Jr. Memorial, and there is the Mountain of Despair, and this is the Stone of Hope coming out of the Mountain of Despair.
What is this?
Work the Pentagon on a Monday, you change 250 light bulbs, go back home, come back on Tuesday, and you know what your job would be? Change 250.
Bunch of them here, and you see the cross that shows that person was a Christian faith. They even have one for atheist people, non-religious believers. There are at least two gravestones here in the cemetery that have an atheist symbol on it, an A with three circles around it. If you are buried in the cemetery, you have to have a religious symbol.
Justices.
me the famous Brown versus the Board of Education case in 1954. And when they procreate that, that legally ended segregation in America's public narrative.
A couple more of them to you before we go on. When it says Holmes right here, that's Supreme Court Justice Oliver Wendell Holmes.
Another high school? And Northside.
He served 34 years on the Supreme Court. He retired at the age of 90. He is our oldest Supreme Court justice. Retired at the age of 90.
President Kennedy's eternal flame. The kids checking it out. Okay, we'll just say it then. What is this quote here?
And so, my fellow Americans, ask not what you can do for your country, but what...
Ask not what your country
can do for you, but what you can do for your country.
Yes. And who said that?
John F. Kennedy.
Thank you, sir.
Marty Murphy over there in Texas, hello. In front of me, behind most of you all, is the mast from the USS Maine. That comes from the Spanish-American War. In 1898, Cuba was trying to establish its independence from Spain. And we sent the USS Maine down to Cuba and tried to establish peaceful relations between those two countries. But if peace could not be achieved, well, we would evacuate our American citizens out of Cuba. Congress approved a resolution providing the burial of one of these unknown soldiers to be placed over here inside Arlington National Cemetery. So on November the 11th, 1921, the unknown soldier that represents all the unknown soldiers of World War I was placed over here in this tomb that you're about to see. That's a thorough inspection that takes place that you're gonna see at 4 o'clock, all right? Thanks.
United States Army, commander of the relief, home of the unknown soldier. A ceremony that you are about to witness is the changing of the guard. In keeping with the dignity of this ceremony, it is requested that everyone remain silent and stand. Thank you. Heart.
That everyone remain silent and standing during this ceremony. All military personnel in uniform will render the hand salute, and it is appropriate for all others to place their right hand over their heart upon the command of present arm. Thank you.
represent all.
So what I'm going to do is go around it slowly once. You keep staring at it and see if you get that same optical illusion. Oh, also these men here, Texas Hero Harlan Block is the one that's closest planting the flag into the ground there. Harlan Block from Yorktown, Texas, yeah. He's buried at the Marine Corps Military Academy in Hollingen, Texas. And he's the one all the way to the left there. Texas Hero, Harlan Block.
Y'all see the optical illusion?
Yeah, after they controlled Marcel Bachi, they continued attacking the rest of the island. As I said, they landed on February 19, 1945, and just 36 days later.
The different pizzas we have here for our meal. We've got some pasta as well as some salad. And here are the guys right here. That's goulash right there. It's goulash. It's white goulash. How you guys doing? Y'all ready to eat?
Good. That's where the helicopter lands. Taking the president to and from the White House on the lawn up there.
Yeah. There's some people voicing their opinions. Palestine will never die. Free Palestine. Free Palestine. White House, here we are. Everybody taking pictures.
Yeah, but the chalk is on the floor.
Get concerned about the $34 trillion debt figure.
Tyler, what do you think?
Social Security is not added one penny to our national debt. So let us know.
So we were just cleared out of this area and put behind the fence. Not sure what's going on over here at the White House. tonight. We have been removed.
No, there's multiple cars.
Korean Memorial. Got these 19 statues. And got the reflection in the mirror, or in the granite. That makes 38. So the 38th parallel. We have arrived at Jenny's and Forrest's reunion in the national pool. Kids are over there taking pictures. And we go over here, they are doing some construction on the Lincoln Memorial. And you have to walk up these steps. Get up there in just a minute. All right, so here's the construction, but you can actually go up the steps. So that's nice. Have a little pathway where you can go up. Look at this, everyone getting their pictures with Abraham Lincoln, Lincoln Memorial. Look at these crazy fools here. Y'all turn around so I can see your faces. Y'all are crazy. And Sammy's doing it without shoes. All right, look at these fools swimming. Hey, Texas! Hey, are you guys tired? Are y'all tired? No? Day two. DC. We are fueling our body this morning at the breakfast buffet.
Buffet.
How y'all feeling this morning?
Good. Got some good sleep.
Some cereal. Good morning. Good morning, sir. Good morning. We're all spread out here. Morning, gentlemen, lady, and Marquez.
Yeah, Marquez is just now on the
way. Happy birthday, dear Kate. Happy birthday to you. And many more.
Day two, first stop, the U.S. Capitol. Do our U.S. Capitol tour. Get everybody, our group coming up here. Excited to see national government in action. All right, now we're on the other side of Liberty Freedom, I think. I think. I could be wrong. They're gonna tell us when. Texas, y'all look back. Wave. Capitol tour. Nation's capital. Look at this.
Ooh.
Going through the Library of Congress tunnel from the Capitol. What's up, guys?
Hi.
It's a lot cooler in here than it is walking outside. So we're headed to the Library of Congress. We are in front of the Library of Congress at the Fountains of the Mermaids. Turtles. Pretty interesting. Market Square, USDA, U.S. Department of Agriculture, have their farmers market.
Iced tea doesn't go good.
Yes, miss.
Iced tea doesn't go good.
Tired, I think I was going to die, but I would hang on to him. I was so afraid they would kill him. I saw them kill babies who were too big to be carried and would give out.
That really was a road of death. People were falling on the side of the road or being shot or being murdered on the road and being left there.
All right, U.S. Capitol. Standing right here in the middle of the National Mall. Going around, and of course, Washington Monument. And it's an Air and Space Museum right there.
I just came out of the Native American History Museum, headed over to the National Archives. This is the National Gallery of Art outside sculpture garden. A lot of cool different things. Jackalope over there. Chairs, I guess. I don't know. Let's see. Some more stuff. Get all the way down there. You got the silver tree, metal tree. The neat installation here. And then you've got the pool or the fountain in here. The fountain actually shoots water into itself. It's nice to just go and sit around there and veg. Here are a few more art installations I wanted to show you. Don't know, have no idea what that is. Or this. Then over here, got an awesome spider. And I know what that is, but I don't know what it is. You know, it was on the cover of Aerosmith's album. And some of them. Look at these guys entering their data here. See if they're going to be, what kind of spy they're going to be. Sammy, you going to be a good spy or a bad spy?
Mm-hmm.
Hey man, don't blow your cover.
Oh. Hey guys.
What's your code word, man?
Yep.
You got a code word?
I already forgot my name.
I took a picture. They are into the game. That one's broken. Nico, you just look like a spy, man. Look at you. Dark glasses. You too.
Yes,
you
sir.
Too, Damien.
Yes, sir.
These guys are into it. Sammy, Jacob, Pila, and Lutz. They're trying to solve the, whatever they're trying to solve, I don't know what it is. They're spies. Okay, Brandon's gonna test his strength here. See if he can make it a minute here. Almost 3 seconds. All right. Let's go, Pila. There you go. You're already doing better than Brandon. All right, you got 10 seconds. Respectable. You lost your mission already? You got found out? But both of y'all are playing this game. Who won this game? Oh yeah, still trying to figure it out.
If you score an encounter, you're crazy. That's disgusting too.
Is that Noah? Got the backpack on. Tyler should be coming behind him. I think. There's Tyler. Going all throughout here. Cross and it'll be coming out this way.
You okay? I want to go back to the truck. What? Is somebody
good? Good. You okay? There he is. You made it.
I was, but
I could hear you underneath there, so I don't know if you would have done it undetected.
They were like, they didn't say I was being too loud though.
Alright. Tyler is stuck maybe? I don't know. Tyler.
There he is.
Stop.
So we have little kids playing a game, and then we have big kids playing a game.
You made me miss a word.
No, I wasn't. It was not to let anyone die.
Kids are having a blast, aren't they?
They are.
And adults.
Purple, brown, white, purple.
What do you mean blue, purple, brown, white? That's
you read the word. I mean, you read.
Oh, you go. You're going like this.
Are y'all figuring it out?
No.
Who reads it like this? You don't read like this.
From left to right. Why do you read like that?
From left
to right.
Do
you read left to right?
Whoa! Whoa! Oh, that's some sisterly love right there, huh? The girls are supposed to be going through the tunnel quietly, but they're not. I can totally hear them. You got Maddie first. She's gonna be detective. She's laughing. She's trying to go slow though. And then Stella is next. So guys, y'all going up there?
Yeah.
Okay. Wait, what is it? Is it?
All right, Maddie's turn. Here we go.
No, I'm not doing it.
Now, grab on.
No, he's recording.
Good.
Go, Maddie.
Oh, wait, I'm swinging.
I will.
Wait, dang, it's a little.
You got to make 10 at least, Maddie.
Oh.
All right, okay, you made 10. Maybe 11. Yeah, that's not very fair at all.
I think so.
So I can fit.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Can you get out now?
Sure.
Bud.
Okay.
Not a challenge. Wait, my ego is still thriving. Once again, baking eight, and my ego is still thriving.
Oh, look at that. Nice. Anybody else?
I got it. What?
Nice.
I'm sick,
Dan.
Bend over.
That's not bad. Okay. Anybody else? The birthday girl. Can she get in? Are her legs too long? Oh. Okay. Good job, Kate.
I can just go in here all day. My neck isn't even that strained.
We'll sit in there for 2 more hours.
Anybody else?
If I could, I would. Good? And I would win.
There we go. Look at Tyler trying to get in here.
Yes, Tyler.
Yes, Tyler. Yes. Good one. All right, Noah. See what you got, Noah.
I'm smaller, but I'm not less.
Yes. That was awesome. Impressive.
That was hard.
Both of you, impressive. Kate's going to demonstrate. There we go. Nice. And now it's your turn.
All right, let's do it. Let's do it.
Yeah.
You know what? This is more comfortable.
Hey, Damien, watch this.
I'm going to make it. I'm going to make it.
Do you think you can?
All right, he's coming in.
I think you can make it. Oh, he's got it. You got it.
Look at this. Look at this. No, that's awesome.
Hey.
That's all.
Okay, I'm glad I didn't have to call an attendant. This is the new normal for Jamie right here. I love it. You'll be all right, Jamie. You'll make it. Day three, we are finished with DC, headed to New York. Would anybody like to volunteer their favorite thing of DC? Just blurt it out.
Arlington.
Lincoln Memorial.
Holocaust.
Pizza? It's better in New York.
We're
going to New York. All right, we good? Y'all ready for New York? All right, we're going through the Baltimore Harbor Tunnel here. Appreciation, Mr. Joe. Thank you very much. Delaware Memorial Bridge, Delaware River. George Washington crossed. First adventure, walking to lunch. Let's go.
Manhattan goes from 59th Street all the way down to 14th Street. Eventually, tomorrow, we're going to touch a little bit of a uptown of Manhattan, and then we go into the downtown of Manhattan. Besides, and that's why they say Ivy League school, because some people get the wrong spelling, but it's a 4 in Romans numerical numbers.
Coming up on St. Patrick's Cathedral, and we're trying to get everybody to pass. You got 10 seconds, hurry! Look at him run. 5. Nicholas doesn't care. Do you care? Do you, Nicholas? Now we're in the inside of St. Patrick's Cathedral. That is the back. Here. glass windows. This church can fit over 2,500 people. And we're about to go up on stage and do our dance.
But first, paint the walls a dark color. The dark color will like do the same thing as when you go to sleep when the sun sets.
Look at this long line for the Stardust.
And what
diner?
With the schools over there. I think they're going there, but through this door. Look at the picture of this guy. That guy, I think when they took that picture, he was around 88 years old. Anybody play guitar? You like electrical guitar? So that's the guy who invented it. All right, so that's.
House of the Dragon, look at this. Advertised in Times Square. It comes on, I forget what today is. I think it's June 15th. Good old Times Square here. Now we're in Times Square. Look at this, yes. Times Square, yeah. Times Square, boys, what do you think? It's the red steps. Coca-Cola. What's up, Harvey's? This guy right here. They're loving that. The gorilla. Here we go, here's some parkour here. Real parkour. New York City. All right, what we got? We got pub food? Is that what we're looking at here?
Yes.
All right. I would like to know who got the most wings. You did? Noah, you're the. All right. How many did you get?
Seven?
Okay. Are you going back?
Yes.
Okay. Nice. Some good pub food, right, guys? Say that again? Okay. Well, ladies.
Come on.
So, if you want to buy a souvenir, check
the price is great. Most souvenir stores, they don't have labels with the price. If they don't have a price, right there.
Times Square. Okay, day four, New York City. Is everybody ready?
Yes.
No.
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 Start. Trip. Trip starting to wear. What's that? Okay. Okay. How was breakfast?
Good.
Good. Reese. Yes, okay. Y'all ready to start day four? Let's go. What's up, guys?
This was created by the Manhattan Indians where we're here. Those are the ones who gave the name to the island, Manhattan. It was something like a Manhattan, this island of the rolling hills. Now, behind me, we have a sponsor to honor Christopher Columbus, and this is Columbus Circle. It was open to public to commemorate.
And all the open space in New York City, Central Park. Vlogging, yes. This is for the video.
No.
You're gonna be a star in my video, Stella.
I don't want
Stella.
Stella means star.
That one. Look at the one on my left. It's kind of white colored. If you notice, some of the floors they're like empty.
and it's done on purpose so that we...
Which song?
All right, take a picture and go around so we can take a nice picture of all of you guys.
Serving all the world, you may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday, yeah, you'll join us.
Raccoon up there, and then there's a cardinal. Oh, there it is. There it is.
You guys got
to there's the cardinal right there.
At the top of the arch, there's a raccoon too.
The Bridge of Love over here. The Love Bridge. I don't know, whatever they call it.
We're gonna stop in front of the fountain, which is the heart of Central Park.
A lot of movies filmed here, this location. Just Friends, for example. JT. Oh, nice. Cooling off. Have a saxophone player playing underneath this bridge.
To stay, but they spread all over Central Park, so now we have turtles everywhere. All right, let's go this way. Oh, by the way, you see there's another Twin Towers over there? So that's the San Remo, and in that building, a lot of people
as well. What's up? What are they doing? What are they doing here? They're getting a drink?
Water.
Museum of Natural History. Where the night at the, what was it? Night at the museum.
Which is the ritual builder center of signage on the opposite side of Central Park.
Getting on here, getting off at 47th Street. 47th Street, this is our first subway ride in New York. Got to make sure we get all 44 people on. We're on. Voila. Let's get their reaction of the kids who don't hold on. You're going to hear us. And, oh. 14 years of doing this. bus terminal here.
When we come out, the front of us is the new headquarters for the New York Times. But that's the building that I thought was about
before. Here is the failing New York Times. Had to stop. I guess they're looking for some albums. Damien's getting really excited about something. Our group is down the road, but look, there we go. I know I got something. What'd you get?
Jackman. I've been wanting.
Oh, hold on. Let me see it. Nice. All right. Is Damien getting something? Come on, we gotta go, Damien.
I'll probably come back.
Okay. And we're on the beast, baby! The beast! Yes! Guys, here's your interview. In one word, describe the beast.
Cold.
Very cold.
Cold.
That, that's two words. That's two words. Very cold is two words.
Vicious.
Vicious. There we go. Cold. Marquez, one word. Describe it.
Exhilarating.
What'd you say?
Exhilarating.
Exhilarating. Okay, I like it. I like it. Okay, what about y'all?
Awesome.
Amazing.
Amazing.
Awesome.
Awesome. Belinda, one word to describe it.
Fast.
Fast. All right, I like it. Okay, Abraham, one word, describe.
Fun.
Fun.
Horrible. I'm cold.
Horrible, cold, that's two.
Okay.
You should just say wet because wet. You are drenched. Absolutely drenched.
Even the kids in the bathroom. Maddie.
Fast.
Fast.
I have a shuttle from NASA.
USS Intrepid.
They use it that to training, so.
And they have a shuttle. NASA shuttle in NASA.
That was the shuttle.
Upper area.
We're gonna go to the other side.
We are waiting on the subway, we're waiting for the subway, 42nd Street. We're trying to go downtown to Battery Park so we can eat lunch. Amazing. We are at the Oculus. World Trade Center, Oculus. Kids, parents are in awe. Belinda, you're in awe. There we go. I'm in a New York pizzeria here. A lot of choices. I am going with that one right there. All of them look really good. Take them and heat them up. That one's not bad either. Pineapple. And they have some other things here too. ...911 Memorial. Just got through doing the inside of the 911 Museum. But this is one of fountains where the World Trade Center, where the tower stood. These are all of the names, people that died in this tower. And then over there is the museum. And then on the other side of the museum over there is the other pool. And it looks exactly like this one.
Found out that these three was standing, a little bit further, but was standing. So they decided to recover the tree. They brought it to the botanical garden. When the whole thing was done, they brought it back. They saw the survival tree.
Survival tree.
And if you notice,
the only tree left. Kids and adults are now at the reflecting pool. And all the names that are on here are all the guys and ladies that died in all the places of the attack. So in Pennsylvania, DC's Pentagon, and the two Twin Towers over here. Now we are at the Oculus on the outside.
Here, the World Trade Center. And there were seven towers. After the attack on September 11, when the two towers collided, they decided to knock down the other five. And the government, not the city, the government says, you know what? Let's have 1784.
Talking about Alexander Hamilton.
The cemetery. We're gonna
see his grave.
Hamilton. And we're also going to look at Fulton,
representing Hamilton, who came up with the Secretary of Treasury.
All right, let's go.
A lot of food trucks. They're having a festival, a Romania festival. The food smells delicious. Grave site of Robert Fulton, inventor of the steamboat. And over here is Alexander Hamilton, his grave site. Festival is awesome. Love this Romanian festival. You got vendors all around. The bowl was extremely packed. The line to try to take a picture is so long. And we got music here on the stage. It is happening in New York, baby. Chinatown. Yes, in New York, baby. New Yorkers. That's fine. There's our usual meeting spot. I guess we're not doing that now. You can see all the Japanese lettering on everything. All the souvenir shops. Souvenir stands. So, all right, kids are about to have some fun in Chinatown. Some more souvenir shops. Get some luggage, some name tags.
Yes. So, the original song is Italian, so the lyric is right
Italy,
so from
right here.
Here. All right, so this is
welcome to Little Italy.
Everything around is Chinatown.
And Chinatown's on the outside.
And the canal. So it's called canal because the Dutch, actually, they opened a canal to connect the two rivers.
Are y'all wheeling and dealing? Yeah. She left. She didn't want to be in the video. Yeah, top secret.
We can't go look and see. Only this.
We are safety.
That's what we she doesn't want to. She don't want to. This definitely looks like Chinatown here. Oh, yeah. Absolutely love it. So this is the Chinese park. And it's like they're, I think they're gambling over here. Playing a game, same thing over there. We have dancers here. So, in Chinatown, right next to the park, we have everyone playing games out here. Soccer. Got volleyball over there. Basketball courts. What New Yorkers do, man. They gotta have a place to vent. So not only do they have Central Park, but they also have these smaller parks as well.
Yes way. Now I'm getting a manicure. What is wrong? Look at all this great food out there. You guys enjoying it?
Yes.
She's not though. She's waiting for the cannoli.
The cannoli is delicious.
It is, it is. Is it good? What do y'all think?
Good.
The wine? Wine's good too?
Mm-hmm.
How's the chicken parm?
Excellent. Excellent.
On the east side, there was a slaughterhouse.
Grand Central Station. A foyer.
The significance is because the architect was inspired by Alice in Wonderland.
Some dragon.
So what happened at the beginning of the movie? Alice gave it to a hole.
Alright, we're headed over here. We're in Grand Central Station now, the big main terminal.
Go, squeeze in, guys. Come on.
Everybody's going to take a look. It is definitely grand.
So, it's just that we know for Grand Central Terminal. And that clock is very important because it is here that Easter Sun.
They are talking to one another over there. And these students are talking to people over there. Okay, leaving Grand Central Station and headed to One Vanderbilt, the summit. Look into a tall building and see a bird's eye view of New York City. Alright, check out the guy's fit. We're all wearing shoes. Or booties. I don't know what you call these. Noah? You look good, Noah. Very fashionable.
You know, fashion forward is my whole brand.
Headed up to Summit Vanderbilt. Seen the views of the city?
Yeah, I took a couple pictures
of it. Awesome.
I'm gonna take one on the bar because we're wearing the same color.
The Chrysler building right here. The East River. Spectacular views of the city. Alright, so check it out. Empire State Building for the House of Dragon, and look, they have a dragon on top of the Empire State Building to advertise. The city has gone all out for House of Dragon. the distance is the Hudson River. It's on the opposite side. And looking down here, that is Times Square where all of those lights are coming from. What a cool experience here. Hit the balls. They go up and then they come back. Love this. Got the fan right here pushing everything up. There's the other side of New York City. And if you look over there where it's dark, somebody popped one. If you look over there where it's dark, that's Central Park. Day five, we are walking to breakfast at 6:15 a.m. Look at Sammy, he's wide open, wide awake.
Look at him, I think he's mad.
Sammy?
Hi.
Okay, all right. How you doing, Dylan? Good. Oh, coach is here. They came down? All right. So our group is a little smaller because some of the adults and families decided to sleep in to get an extra 30 minutes of sleep. Well deserved. All right, head to breakfast in New York and then we head to Boston. Look, it's Magnolia Bakery from Lazy Sunday and it's attached to Rockefeller Center, Tonight Show, Jimmy Fallon. Now I finally get the reference after all these years. Damien, explain why that is your breakfast this morning.
Why these chicken tots are my breakfast? Yeah. You want me to explain why these chicken tots are my breakfast?
Yes.
It's because of tater tots, sir.
You're a tater tot fan?
Yes, sir. I prefer like tater tots than french fries.
He took like 40 minutes to serve himself.
Yeah. How is it?
It's good.
Yeah. We are in Connecticut at a stop. Had to go to a restroom stop and a quick snack stop on our way from New York to Plymouth and then Boston. So this is our quick stop.
Yeah, why don't we get a boat and we'll go over? And that's what they decided to do. So what do you think, guys? You get a boat and you gotta go 3,000 miles to a whole new location? Is that gonna cost anything? Yeah, you gotta buy a boat.
H-E-R-E. What is that over there? We say, oh, you mean over there?
Over there.
Where, what is the focal point of Harvard? It's Harvard Square. Harvard Square, Harvard Square. And guys, you know what we do here? This is crazy. we take words that end in A and make them sound as if they end in ER. So you guys, it's even hotter in San Antonio than it is in Florida. Florida. You're going to get a couple more views of it today, guys, later on today.
Dick, how much will we be looking at one of these houses right here?
Oh, gosh.
The Atlantic Ocean.
Very, very expensive. Probably.
We have arrived at Plymouth Visitor Center. Mayflower right there.
Did any of your family members die on the way over? What are you doing to make a living? Are you kids? Do the kids go to school here? Do they learn how to read? Any questions you have, and I'm going to come in and kind of prod a few conversations.
But you're
going to
watch him because he's a teacher. And so if you notice that bear going back to a certain bush, you knew that that bush was safe for you to eat from. Before you're scratching at a certain tree, you knew that that tree was either fake.
Big canoe, Wampanoags used. This is a living museum here at Plymouth, Puxetit. I don't know if I said that right or not. They are, I think this is corn. Here is home. Historic styrofoam.
99.9% of it.
We're in the hut.
It depends what community you are interacting with. So there was communities at the end of the town and house that had more interactions with the Europeans, and frankly violent interactions. There's a first encounter.
Oh, I want to be out in that water.
The replica of the town. About to head down there. Plymouth.
This would be used for catching fish. Yeah. You can put like a, or crabs.
Yeah.
Put like a bait back here.
Like a trap.
Yeah. Okay. Keep giving us the tour. You're being videoed here.
So obviously beds, armors, butter churning. Right, all has to be done inside the house. So everything to cook through the fireplace, right? And each house had a specific job, whether they were guards, cooks, blacksmiths, carpenters, farmers.
Mistaken, unfortunately. This heat of the country is not a hot day, in fact, even. Just a few weeks ago, it was still cold. It's a very late spring here, and then it gets hot almost immediately, hotter than this. And so any English grains that we grow, they don't grow to be very tall, and then they just sort of scorch.
So no meat.
What's that got to do with grain?
Beer.
Right, beer. That's why I was talking about grains. But if you want to talk about honeybees, no, there are none here either.
Mead
from honey?
Or beer?
No.
No?
Mead is a specific drink similar to wine made out of honey.
Yeah. Abraham doesn't know.
Yeah, but that's, I couldn't fault you for not knowing that. I mean, it's, you're young like me. You're not our grandparents' age when they were drinking that.
Of course my husband is a very important man in town. He has a lot of duties to the colony.
He is away a great deal of the time, but he does his duties well.
Is this his chainmail?
Yes. Every man in town has armor. There's no standing army here, of course. There are only 150 of us. So all of the men must learn skills of sword on pike on musket to defend the town should the need arise.
It's mostly every family in a home. There are some 20 men here who can go to the family.
My daughter is three. Her name is Elizabeth. What is your name?
I have spent three.
Have you lost? Did you lose anybody?
My family has been very blessed that, we did not lose anybody yet. But some families, especially those who are on Mayflower, I can scarcely imagine. 102 passengers and only 50 survived the next year.
How's it coming along?
Did you get it yet?
Yeah, the other
we got flour yet?
She knew exactly what I was talking about.
You feel you've been vindicated?
Yes.
Because she did not know what mead was, man.
No, the other one did not know what mead was.
That was honey, honey from bees.
Right.
That house there, right here. We did because of its proximity to the town brook. But English grains do not grow well here. No honeybees to be found. A lot of good places to graft an orchard, but no orchard fruits are even found here naturally, as many berries as there are. Mm.
Other than water, what do you drink?
Well, there's really, as I just went through all there's hardly other options.
That's it.
Because English grains do not grow well here, and honeybees cannot be found, and several good places to graft orchards, but you won't find orchard fruits, no pears, no apples.
Mm. Oh, man. What? And sir, can you explain who you are and what you are doing?
I am Sir Abraham. I am the garrison's captain. I am the protector of these people.
And? That's it? Are you married?
I am not, sir.
You are. You have a baby cradle in your home.
The baby I traded to the Indians for some mead and a fine canoe.
Why are you sweeping the dirt?
She's sweeping the floor.
Why is there
you?
This is her. This is like her bedroom, her actual bedroom.
I don't live like this.
Let me get the shoes on real quick.
Okay, drip. Yeah, you gotta fit.
These are old Birkenstocks.
Hey, you're a talking goat. Yeah, I can talk.
Here, goat. Come here, goat.
Yeah, button hook me. Check out my lobster in Boston. They got me a lobster. Lobster, say it.
Lobster.
Attack us, but we've had diverse fights with Indians in this country. But every man here between 16 and 60 is expected to have musket and sword and armor to them in case of attack. How long is that thing?
Okay, we are. Oh, really?
Yeah.
You want? Okay. Well, here you be first. Now we've got proof. You were the first one on the bus. Or not the bus, the boat. All right. Let's come over here. We're on the Mayflower. We're coming over and gonna get oriented on the boat. This is a replica of the Mayflower.
We still want the captain seeing, but the captain's going to be yelling down a heading. Direct command.
Then I come out and I got to figure out what direction we got to travel in. I yell it down.
We're going to the second deck.
or the middle deck, I guess.
Nice.
This cabin here is your steerage cabin, so you're going to be steering the ship from in here. And to steer the ship, you're just using this large lever right here called the whipstaff. The whipstaff will just be moving side to side.
Go. You see it, Damien?
Yeah.
Noah?
Oh,
no, no, go ahead, Noah. No, go.
Can we take a bacon? Can I go?
What do you see, Noah?
I can dock.
There you go. Get a cage.
Oh, wow, look at this.
Good stuff. Okay, now we are definitely below deck here.
And they're not like you and me. They don't hold a lot. And when you hold, you probably get
hey, Sammy.
A lot of the stuff you use it.
Smile.
I mean, that's the way I do it.
It's a great smile, Sam. Nicholas, what do you think about the Mayflower?
It's cool.
Would you like to be on this ship for 6 weeks? No?
So this is like 20 bucks. I would no other
one. You got down to 20. You got down. Okay, hold on. Let me get the
mail. I don't want to be here.
Bro, you like that old ass hair? Just leave it alone.
There's Marquez's. Coming down is one happy family right there. Look at him.
How are you recording?
Barely, 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 barely. Life is but a dream.
Wow. Where do you want to go? We'll take you.
I'm sure that the workers love when groups come through. Groups of kids.
My eardrums.
Oh, you know what?
I missed. You had to be there.
Oh, my ears. I missed.
All right, that's enough. There's always one annoying one. Not really sure how safe this is, but the kids just really want to be on the rocks. Okay, all these guys are pondering life as we know it. At least that's what I told them to do. I think they're probably just thinking about dinner tonight.
Famous American symbol because it's where the pilgrims first landed. And what year again, guys? You all ought to know this by now.
1620.
There you go. All right.
It's right there.
We got it. We got it. Yeah, not hard. Not hard.
So this is where we just were, where Plymouth Rock is. It's in there. Below, we're just waiting right now for the bus to come, and that may be it. And I came up here just to take a picture.
The building left of that is the third tallest. Those are the three tallest buildings. We'll go right down near them, actually. We'll have time to do that.
and we stare straight ahead. We're looking at what's called the financial district. You know, the banks, insurance companies, all those people are mostly up and mostly straight ahead of us. So the city kind of spreads out. Unbelievable disaster that had just taken place. Anybody know what it was? Yep. What? Did I hear back there? It was the sinking of the Titanic. Okay. Yeah, you tell what an incredible disaster. You know, the country basically shut down for a few days, if you can believe that. But it did. Years of operation, the Red Sox won the World Championship four times in 7 years. But then, in 1919, disaster struck. No, that's right, but it was a very popular television show set in Boston, even though it was filmed in Los Angeles. But at any rate, it's coming up on the right, right next to the white awning here on the right. You'll see a staircase going downstairs, and that goes into the Cheers bar.
Sometimes you wanna go where everybody knows your name.
That's right. It's a place where everybody knows your name. It's a neighborhood bar. You go in there and feel comfortable. Yeah, naturally. Kind of leafy green, actually, especially this time of year. It's a pretty, I think the word is elegant. Okay, guys, meaning kind of uppity. Highfalutin.
Highfalutin, that's a good word.
That sounds like a Texas word, huh? Yeah. Up on the left, everybody, we'll go over the highway first, and then we'll... Yeah, then we'll see. You can see the lights of the ballpark now on the left, everybody. Okay?
Oldest ballpark in the U.S.
However you want it. Yeah, I don't...
We're going over the Big Poppy Bridge.
Yeah, that's right. The Big Poppy Bridge. That's correct. And there is the green monster, everybody. You see the big, high left field wall? See a couple of signs there that are in. And right below that is the green monster.
Down this lane, you'll have a banner that says, "Welcome to Fenway."
Yeah. Can we circle it, do you think, Juan? I guess we can, yeah. Guys, we're going to circle the ballpark. And hey, how about a big shout-out to Juan for doing
that? Yeah!
All right. This part of town is not the most bus-friendly section of the city. As you can see by the turn we're making.
Welcome to Fenway right there.
But anyway. We are right under the left field wall right now, guys. Okay.
We are able to have a quick photo shoot here at Fenway. We're not seeing a game, but we get to have a little quick photo shoot and see the statues that are here. Fenway Park. And not everybody got off the bus, only the ones that were interested, which looks like most adults and a few boys, I guess. Tyler wanted to, nice. Tyler, I think you're the only boy from our group. Salad and stuff over there. So I put three bowls worth of stuff over there. You can tell the difference between mine and everyone else's. Look at how big that is compared to the other one. Go big or go home, baby. There's the rest of our crew out there. All right, what do y'all think about this place? Best one on the trip? Nicholas, what do you think? Are you peer pressure to say yes or no? Gosh, good. Are y'all going back or did y'all already go back? Yeah, I don't need to go back, but I'm going back right now. Here's some more of our crew. Got their stuff. Kids over there.
So you're in that 13 to 15 age group, and I know that the one you're not interested in beautiful buildings, all that. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on it. But guys, you are walking on Commonwealth Avenue, and this is considered one of the most beautiful city streets, certainly in this country, and maybe in the world. So if nothing else, guys, as you walk down and realize that really the beauty of the street, both sides of the streets, stunning late 19th century architecture, this beautiful promenade. You know, back in the late 1800s, the roads were dirt roads, they were narrow. And here we have this wide thoroughfare with a big promenade right down the middle of it. So this is kind of...
So we're in the beautiful commons here. And look at Brandon Lutz. He's playing baseball on his phone.
Sir, we're seeing who's going to... It's the Marlins in the...
It's the Marlins versus the Cardinals.
Yeah. We're seeing who's going to win. We're going for the Marlins.
Whatever. Now we are headed to the tavern. Popularized, known as Cheers. Okay, what do y'all think of Cheers?
So far, so good.
That's cool. Like the show.
What do you say in the back?
This is Cheers. Very, very small. No, it is not what you think, but there's Diane, a young Diane, and Ted. Got their... Right. More Cheers upstairs. Oh, okay. It does go back here. Of course, you got Celtic stuff here in Boston. And...
Do we have to go back?
Are you okay?
Cheers set bar. Oh, nice.
You can't be getting drunk going up these stairs.
Okay, so now we're up. You got the gang right here. Yes. So cool. Norm! Okay, and they have a huge gift shop here. Okay, Jamie, I said 2 minutes, so.
I got a bite in the
You better hurry up. We gots to go. Here's the a bar. Love it.
She played college basketball, so she is a big Celtics fan. Okay.
All capital, right. And they're representing the Celtics because the Celtics can wrap up the NBA championship tonight against the Dallas Mavericks in Boston if they win. And we are here.
Jacob Bridge, Z A K I M. All right, guys.
Boston.
Yeah. DD Gordon, right here, guys.
And here is the guard.
We are within a gnat's eyelash of watching the basketball game right here on the right.
Right at the game, guys. Okay, guys. Right at the game.
All right. Yeah. The finals.
Yeah, look, right by the Boston Celtics. Yeah.
49 years ago today.
Wow.
Okay, so you are here for the anniversary.
Day 6, Boston. Y'all ready for your last day?
Yeah.
How do you love food? Just pretty hungry.
Anything else y'all want to say?
I miss sweet tea and tacos.
America.
You miss sweet tea and tacos.
Yeah, right. We don't really get that here.
No, not in Boston. Or New York. Kate, did you eat something?
Yeah.
Did you eat something?
No.
No? You don't want anything?
Okay.
Oh, okay. Jacob, are your parents still alive?
They're good here now.
Okay.
He was throwing them back left and right.
I want blueberries on each side of my muffin.
You know how long that's going to take? Equal amount on both sides.
Equal amount on both sides. Do you know how long that's going to take?
Mystic River right here.
And a look out to the left. Now the airport is to the left. Can I just see the tall building with the kind of ball on top? That's the airport. That's where we'll be later today. The airport, only 1 mile from downtown. That's that. You see that crane, everybody? Take a look to your left, right by that crane in just a second, and you're going to see the oldest ship in the United States Navy, the USS Constitution. You see the masts right there, and you'll get a little bit of a look at it right through the slot right here, just barely. But anyway, we'll be going to it. There you go, just barely get a look at it there. And then we'll be going to that. The steaming kettle. See it there on the right, the steaming kettle. And that was part of a business called the Steaming Kettle, a coffee shop that dates all the way back to 18, is buried right in there. John Winthrop was his name. And for you adults, he made a speech on the way over here, giving everybody a pep talk. When we get to Boston, we're gonna build a shining city on the hill. And for those old enough to remember, that was a campaign slogan used by Ronald Reagan in his two presidential campaigns. Walk over in this direction. I'll just start out though. This is going to be the very beginning of the Freedom Trail. What is the Freedom Trail? Freedom Trail is a pathway that in 1958 was opened to connect all of the historic sites together. Follow the path and you'll see them all. We won't do all of them today. We're gonna do quite a few of them, okay? For the next couple of hours, and then later on today, this afternoon as well. Now, this property, guys, you can do if you decide, I don't wanna hear this guy talk. If I hear one more word out of him, I'm gonna go crazy. Massachusetts State House, okay? This is the third oldest state house in America. Maryland and Virginia have older state houses. And this one opened in the year 1798. Only in an old place like Boston could we call it
the new State House, even though it was built in 1798. What do you think of it, guys? Kind of pretty, isn't it? Kind of handsome?
Freedom Trail right here.
On the first bricks of the Freedom Trail. And as we walk, we will go on and often, but as we walk, whenever you see these bricks, this brick pathway, you'll know that you're on the Freedom Trail. Okay? So I'm right at the beginning. It starts right here. Okay, so with that, we'll actually follow it across the street. Right here.
It's always best to start at the beginning. So follow the yellow brick road. 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 And now the Freedom Trail is going to go across the street that way. And then you see it go that way. And then into the Boston Commons.
Resolutely. Really walking, we are ready to fight for our people's rights. And you can, this is a very expressive sculpture. I'm sure nobody here is a sculpture expert. That includes me, by the way. But this is considered. Well, it was a man named Reverend William Blackston. Reverend Blackston was the chaplain of another group that tried to colonize between Boston and Plymouth in the 1620s, and it failed. It didn't work out. Better remember, guys,
Boston
we talked
Commons
about this yesterday.
This is the oldest park in America. 50 acres.
Fishing and lumber, but they don't know fishing.
Hear the bells. Church over there.
It's time for the Harvard-Yard lecture.
Crazy Bostonian right here. I think he got in a fight with that guy over there talking to the other cop. Very interesting. I would love to stay and see how this plays out, but we gotta go.
Over there in the corner, over here, all over these places, is Samuel Adams.
Samuel Adams over here. And Herbie Hancock over here.
Who's this?
John Hancock. It's a Tommy Boy reference. Franklin?
What city do we associate Benjamin Franklin with?
Philadelphia.
Philadelphia, don't we? So that can't be Ben, can it? But guess what, guys? He was born in Boston in 1706. How many of you guys have had, an occasional argument? We're gonna start taxing you. Why did they do that?
Got some competition with his
What made them
speech,
do that, guys?
History lesson.
What? The French
the
and
kids
Indian
are more
War.
Interested in
what was that all about? Any idea?
Than
what
they
was that
are
all about, you think?
Listening.
Go ahead, follow up. Go
to
ahead.
Our tour guide.
We went to war with especially yeah. France.
And some adults.
The British went to war with France. Okay, great. Okay, Xavier is going to tell us two facts about John Hancock. Go ahead, the floor is yours. All right, I hear your name is Nicholas. All right, Nicholas.
He's got to read.
Tell us something about facts. Paul. Tell us two things about Paul Revere. Go right ahead, sir.
So he had a copper business, and he participated in the Boston Tea Party.
Okay, he had a copper business and participated in the Boston Tea Party. Yes. How did, he was a tradesman. He was a copper smith, a gold smith.
Good job,
smith.
Nicholas.
What's a smith?
And the Freedom Trail continues. We're right next to Suffolk University. You know just got through going to the graveyard of Paul Revere, Samuel Adams, and John Hancock. Thank you for the reminder. Dylan? Mm-hmm. You are learning. Ah, Tyler gotcha. Boston is lively today. We've had a lot of police, not the transit police, but two more just came by. couple of fire trucks, the real police. It's lively today. Look at Damien over here. Just sat down. He's out. Here's a great example of gentrification. The Ruth Chris Steakhouse is in the old city hall. How about that? Would that be gentrification?
Free here at the Old South Meeting House that was built in 1729
was built.
95 years old, and it is famous because it was in that meeting house. This is a commemorative stonework commemorating the Boston Massacre. The massacre, everybody, took place right out in the middle of the street. That's where it took place. And there was a soldier guarding the customs house right down by the street green. And these two guys walked down there and they started, 16, 17-year-old guys, and they started taunting the soldier, as I told you. Engravings were made.
Here comes the
it's
duck.
Brought up here on horseback, and on July 18, 1776, the Declaration of Independence was
finished.
That was built in 1742. Why is Sam Adams here? Because a lot of the arguments that he made in favor of independence, they were made on the second story of Faneuil Hall. For that reason, the building is called the Cradle of Liberty. Now, Sam Adams spoke there a lot. You see, you might see a sign on a pole. Sam Adams speaking at Faneuil Hall tonight at 6:30. And everybody would show up. 2 weeks later, he's speaking again. And everybody would show up. But if you've seen him once, why would you go see him again and again? You know why? What else are you going to do? You finish dinner at 6 o'clock. Half the year, it's pitch black. You only have candlelight. Memorial. You guys study the Holocaust at all? You have, so you're familiar with what happened then when Hitler attempted to exterminate the Jewish population of Europe.
So this is the Holocaust Museum Memorial. And instead of having the names of the victims that died, they have the numbers on the outside. And as you walk through, there's steam that comes out that represents the ovens in which they were burned. These are all for the Jewish population, the 6 million Jews. And there are six towers as you go through here. And all six towers represents 1 million Jews murdered.
USS Constitution!
About to enter the USS Constitution. Coming up. 226 years old. Entering the USS Constitution. Yesterday was the Mayflower. Now, the USS Constitution. Exploring the USS Constitution. Wow, this ship has a lot of cannons. Oh man, I got that on video. I was just about to tell you, you're gonna have to watch out on here, but it was too late, I'm sorry. There are a lot of cannons on this boat. Kate, what do you think? Which one's cooler, this one or the Mayflower?
This one.
This one, yeah, I'm gonna have to agree with you on that. Okay, I'm just getting this on video just in case something happens to her. The School Tours of America is not responsible for your negligence. Here's our experiment. Coach Vasquez has to duck down. We got Jamie. She has to duck down. And look at Maddie. Nothing. Nothing at all. And then we get back to Kate. Kate has to. There we go. Oh, and you got to drop down too. Or is it just your hair? Is it just your hair again? Oh, it is your head. Yeah. Yeah. Nice. Nice. And then Stella has to drop down as well. So these are the officers' quarters. And this is the vacant room here. Not very big, but definitely more spacious than the rest of the soldiers. Oh yeah, okay, this one has got a desk in here. Yeah, thanks, Kate. And there's the bunk bed, yep, with the desk. Or not the bunk bed, the cot. Freedom Trail continues and takes us to the USS Constitution. Seeing the USS Constitution, and it's hot outside. We're in the museum / gift shop, and everybody's trying to catch their breath and catch some cool air.
Charge the fucking the central rotunda. Take your food, try to get a seat in there. Restrooms are below the rotunda. And guys, if you look down about halfway down this side that I'm pointing to, you'll see a
about to go to lunch here.
There's the one with the anchor, and then the one further down, that is best of.
This is my lunch here. Got New England clam chowder, a lobster roll, all of this right here. It's $46. I got it here at the Wicked Lobster in Boston, Massachusetts. And I know I'm doing a horrible accent, but I don't care. They have a lot of stuff here. And they even have a 1 pound lobster roll for $88. Lobster pie. It's like macaroni and cheese. We're in the big food hall, Quincy, something or another. This is our lunch for today. Okay, you're doing the body impression. Now you gotta fall asleep. We are now about to come to Paul Revere's house. Kids are excited about seeing that. Although they're really tired. I think most of them just want to hurry up and get to the airport. But we have two more things to do, and this is one of them.
One of the teachers at the Revere House. The Revere House is this wooden building right behind me, and we're going to go over there in just a second. But I'm going to use this space over here just to talk to you a little bit about this guy, Paul Revere. You guys been studying about him?
He looks like Jack Black.
He does, doesn't it? I think Jack Black looks like him because he's first. So, yeah. What have you guys been learning about Paul Revere? What's he famous for?
The British Rebellion, right?
The British Rebellion. Let's go get it, guys.
Most people, a lot of people have seen that picture, the real picture, like a regular family. When we go inside, some of the rooms are pretty small, especially the first one we're going into, so we're going to divide into smaller sections so that we can fit into the rooms. You guys can chill here in the shade, and I will come.
All right, here is the house, Paul Revere House. Now we are going to our very last stop of the trip before we go to the airport. This is the Old North Church. This is obviously where all of the treasure was found, a national treasure. Nicolas Cage found it. And of course, they're looking at the historical aspect, and the girls are looking at a cat. Not just a real cat, but a fake cat.
The independence of our country. We're always trying to protect that independence.
And doing selfies with their
tongue. And of course, we've had wars ongoing ever since. How many of you guys?
Guys, Mari.
Right down the stairs, guys. Everybody.
We are inside the North Church now. Looks like Kate owns this pew. Congratulations, Kate. These girls had to pitch in because they're poor to buy the pew together. They're not as rich as Kate. And these boys are wealthy landowners. And they have theirs. Interesting church. This is not what it looks like on National Treasure. These are the original candles, according to Abraham, anyways. I don't know if this is true or not, but so the candles that were lit to notify the colonists, one by land, two by sea. Again, that is from Abraham Frias. I'm not sure if that is accurate information or not. This is the last bit of the Freedom Trail that we're going to see. We are done with the tour. Everybody's leaving the Old North Church without treasure, I mind you. And we're headed up this hill to go catch the bus and get on our airplane and come home. It's been a great trip.
When we talk about things like the American Revolution, talk about the politics, should we be independent or not? And we talk about old military campaigns, Lexington and Concord. We don't focus a lot on the people. These British soldiers, they came over here in the summer of 1774.
Last time we are loading the bus. We are loading to go to the airport to come home. Or to go home. Are y'all excited to go home?
Yes.
But y'all had a good trip.
Yeah. Very nice.
Boston. There's the Boston Harbor right there. Okay, last video of the trip. We're home. It's Sentai Airport waiting to be picked up. Waiting for our luggage to come out here. Nicholas, did you enjoy yourself?
Yeah.
Okay, on a scale from 1 to 10, what would you rate it?
9.
A 9? Why take away the 1 point? What could have been better?
Boston.
Boston?
Yeah.
What's that? Like more time there? Or what? You just didn't like Boston?
Yeah, it's kind of boring.
It's kind of boring. Yeah, history stinks, doesn't it?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, I'm glad you had fun, though. Damien?
Yeah.
Okay, what was your favorite part of the trip? You're next, Lutz. Be ready. Okay, I'm gonna go to you now.
Okay, I would say the baseball game. Go Marlins.
Yeah, the baseball game.
The one where you guys lost money?
Yeah.
By betting me something stupid?
Maybe. Oh, yeah, and now we're fans of
the Marlins?
Yeah.
They just won today.
Yeah.
That's awesome.